Hello, you're right. We're here with Swallownest Fan TV and we're here to just ask you a few questions about the club as a whole.
Yeah, no problem.
Tell us a bit about yourself and your role here at the club.
So I'm a joint assistant manager. I came in from Hallam last season. I was part of their management team up there. The gaffer brought me in beginning of the season just to help him with different things such as recruitment and obviously match day involvement. So that's myself. And we're getting a good nucleus, a good group down here.
How do you think the team has done as a whole this season so far?
We started off a little bit sticky. Obviously it's a new adaptation, but I think we've now sorry. I had to laugh at that. So I think now we've started to kick on a little bit, find his own way in the game. Obviously with the gaffers, he's class and we've got a good philosophy of football.
Do you think with this current run of form that they've got going that they've got the chance of pushing for like a playoff spot?
I hope so. Basically, it's got to be consistency really. I mean, we had two midweek games where we were contrasting fortunes. Two games last week, contrasting fortunes, where on a different day we'd have come out of 3 points in either. But it's just about kicking on really from here. Tough game today though, he's a good team.
When you aren't co-managing at Swallownest, what do you like to do in your spare time?
Oof, play guitar. Bit of a Liam Gallagher, you know what I mean? Liam Gallagher. A bit kind of that kind of music. Keeping away from missus as much as I can. Not too keen on that one. Apart from that, not much really. A Sheffield United fan. That's it really.
If you could have any player, past or present, to sign for Swallownest, who would that player be?
What? Pro or non-pro?
In the world.
In the world? Oh, Jesus. Bruno Ribeiro.
And why is that?
You'll never see Bruno Ribeiro. Sheffield United hero. Many, many years ago. None of these lads will even know Bruno Ribeiro is. I think you're in my fantasy team. I think that's what it was. I don't know. Yeah, Bruno Ribeiro, my favourite player growing up. But currently, I think we need to see Gaffer playing a bit more.
And for any aspiring young person that wants to go into sort of your role to football, what advice would you give them and why?
Be patient, be forthright, be patient, and just try and make sure that your philosophies as a group and obviously as a management team are all correct. That's the way we need it to be. Consistency and obviously just doing it that way really, being honest with each other.
Thank you.
Top man, all the best.
Cheers, mate.
Cheers, thank you.
So we're here with Jack Haslam and Mark Adiel. Just got some questions for you boys for the game. So start with Jack. How do you think you've done as a player this season so far?
When I've played, I think I've done all right. I've struggled a few games with injuries. Me and Mark have both had a bit of a dodgy hamstring recently, so it's not been ideal. But yeah, when we've played, I think we're doing probably better than we'd expect at the start of the season. I think we've got a good group, so good.
Mark, tell us a bit about yourself and your role here at the club.
I'm the striker, so my name is Mark, obviously I'm a striker. I came in, obviously the team welcomed me well, and it's been great. Great bunch of lads, great setup. It's been really good, yeah.
What are the both of you hoping to get out to this game?
I mean, obviously they're Campion, I think they've won every game apart from one draw, so they're going to lose at some point, so hopefully we can be the team that gets them 3 points, but just got to go out there and put a bit of graft in and see what comes of the game, really.
For any aspiring footballer, Mark, what bit of advice would you give to him?
Just keep working hard, never give up. There will be setbacks, you know, but you've just got to keep going, never stop, and just keep believing in yourself and, you know, trust in your ability. That's it.
Jack, when you aren't playing for Swallownest, what do you enjoy doing in your spare time?
Oh, that's a tough one. I mean, I like chilling out, watching a film, TV series at home with missus and that. That's a nice relaxer.
Mark, if you could have any player from anywhere in the world, past or present, sign for Swallownest, who would that be?
It's got to be Ronaldinho for me. Just the tricks, the entertainment. It would be amazing to have someone like that on the team.
And for the both of you, what's your score prediction for today?
Oh, come on, we've got to be ambitious, haven't we?
2-1 Swallownest.
Yeah, I was going to say the same as well. Let's do it.
All right, thank you for your time.
Cheers, lads.
See you. Good luck with the game.
Thanks, mate.
Hello, Zach.
Hi.
Welcome to this interview. And just got some questions for you about today's game and your career as a whole. So just tell us a bit about yourself and your role here at Swallownest.
Goalkeeper. Well, I like to think I'm anyway. Been down here since probably a year now, just before Christmas last year. Obviously part of the side that stayed up last year. And then obviously building to what we're doing now. But yeah, enjoy it down here. Physiotherapy student as well. Yeah, local lad. Good.
How do you think you've done as a player this season so far?
I've been alright. I said first game, played against Wolfsburg, first game of the season, won 1-0. Had a good game. And then injured after that, out for a couple of weeks, and then come back in. Groovy's been doing well, so I had to sit on sidelines for a little bit and then come back in, started playing well. Had a bit of an off week, and then obviously red card last Saturday. So,
big welcome to everybody.
Touchline today, but yeah, not been too bad. Team as a whole is doing really well.
Do you think that Swallownest have what it takes to fight for a place in the playoffs this season?
Yeah, I'd say so. I think some of the teams above us, what I've seen, have not been sort of anything what I've expected them to be. So sort of, obviously, the way we've been playing as well, we've been doing really well. So yeah, believe top six, I think that's the aim, definitely. No game we can't really lose, to be honest. Going to every game, thinking we can win everyone.
Do you think that the team's done well this season, or do you think they're under or overachieving?
Yeah, we're doing very well, to be honest. Sort of compared to last season, brought a lot of good quality in. Like I said, I think top six is a realistic sort of aim and achievement. It'd be something the club's never done before. So we had a chat the other day about it. The team's never finished higher than 10th. So I think that's sort of, obviously we're aiming to finish above that, and obviously as a good aim, top six, definitely.
If you could have any player, past or present, from anywhere in the world sign for Swallownest, who would that player be?
Good question. At the minute, I'd probably have to say Kevin De Bruyne, just that little bit of quality. Just sort of that midfield runner who can just add goals, adds a bit of everything.
And one final question, for any aspiring young footballer, what's one bit of advice that you give to them and why?
Work hard, definitely, and take your chances when they come to you. Just sort of always push on and never give up on what you want to achieve.
Right, thank you for
your time. Cheers.
Hello, I am your match commentator, Sonny Bostock, and today we will be commentating and reviewing the match of Swallownest FC versus Campion AFC, match sponsor Elitus, Doors, Windows and Conversions. If you would like to find more information about them, please call 0330 1755 790. Just before kickoff, we will be having a minute of silence in respect for the war veterans, and then we will kick off. So today's lineups for Swallownest FC: in net we have Stephen Booth, number 2 is Leighton Sawyer, number 3 is Ash Cooper, number 4 is James Bythway, number 5 is Owen Hay, number 6 is Connor Williamson, number 7 is Sean Dickinson, number 8 is William Montero, number 9 is Liam Frost, number 10 is Ollie Grady, and number 11 is Oliver McQuinlan. For Campion, in net we have Bradley Emerson, number 2 we have Ethan Crossley, number 3 we have Marcus Harper, number 4 we have Cam Fitzgerald, number 5 we have Daniel Illingworth, number 6 we have Michael O'Brien, number 7 we have Nicky Boshwell, number 8 we have Joseph Colley, number 9 we have Marcus Day, number 10 we have Aidan Day, and finally in number 11 we have Patrick Skies. Today's mascots are Callum Sharp and Evan Sharp. Well done. Minute of silence over. Coming up next, we have Swallownest FC versus Campion FC.
Just for confirmation, Swallownest will be playing in the blue and white kits this afternoon.
Whilst Campion will be playing in the red and black. Alright, so. And it's kickoff!
Ollie Grady gets it started.
Ollie Grady gets it started. Okay, so by the looks of it, we have a 3-2-5 coming from Campion FC, a very attacking team. If you did not know this, as of this match, they have not lost yet this season. Well, every team has to lose, and could this be the match that they lose? So it's now a goal kick.
Corner kick.
Corner kick, is it?
Corner kick, Swallownest.
Corner kick, Swallownest. That is a very early corner to have. Obviously, you don't want to be conceding corners this early on because they can be very dangerous. And we have seen more than once Swallownest score from a corner kick this season.
Be Ollie Grady to whip the ball in.
Ollie Grady. It's in.
Lovely ball.
And.
Campion game.
Campion have gained possession of the ball. They. We've seen them thwart every long ball this game, and it is now a Campion throw-in. Oh, this will be
looks like it's going to be a long throw-in into the box now. It's a lovely ball.
Okay, and that is Swallownest once again winning the air.
Get away!
Oh,
lovely save.
Good save from Stephen Booth. Good save. Frost.
Played forward.
That's played forward. Unfortunately, William Montero could not regain possession and Campion now have the ball. Very good regain of possession there. As I've said before, they're very good in the air. That is going to go out for a goal kick to Campion. Number six. Oh.
Very nice tackle by the Nest. Out comes the goalkeeper. And he's cleared it.
If in doubt, get it out.
Into the construction that site. Appears to
be, that appears to be the motto of their goalkeeper. If in doubt, get it out. And he was in doubt, so what did he do? He did get it out.
It's exactly going to restart seeing.
They're having to climb into the construction site. No, I'm just joking. It has been played back out.
And
we're not sure what's happened there.
An own goal by number two.
But that appears to be. Yes, that is a goal for Campion FC.
I think it's more fair to us.
Unfortunately, that might be an own goal.
It's quite unlucky to concede. I think they were more switched off due to the fact that the ball had gone over, so they weren't probably expecting the throw-in. But
Swallownest have been playing extremely well. They did not deserve to concede that goal. They've been absolutely great in the defence, and obviously I believe they have the facilities to win this game.
Very good clearance. It's going to drop.
It's not the best clearance though, because Swallownest still have possession. That's gone to number Ollie. 10, number 8. Whoa.
Fired out.
Out to number 3, Ollie Grady. That's not Ollie Grady, I'm very sorry, that is Ash Cooper. And that is not a free kick for Nest, despite numerous claims of a push on number 9.
Liam Frost, I've got to say that I agree with that call.
That is a throw-in for Campion.
Great, he's able to tap it into the middle. It's a shot by Swallownest that unfortunately sails over, and that will be half time.
That has been a very eventful first half of Swallownest FC versus Campion FC, sponsored by Elitis Windows, Doors and Conversions. Just for further iteration, if you'd like to know more about our sponsor, Elitis Windows, Doors and Conversions, please call 0330 1755 790.
Now, it's been a very good half for Swallownest. We think that they've been the side on top, despite popular belief that they were probably going to get dominated by a side that has played obviously very well this season to be top of the table and undefeated. But they've been able to hold their own, and they've been able to create some chances, obviously, with that shot towards the end of the first half. And hopefully in the second half, they're able to create something and create a bit of danger that allows them to grab some goals and hopefully get the win. So at half time, it is Swallownest 0, Campion AFC 1.
Hello, and welcome to the second half of Swallownest FC versus Campion FC. Match sponsor Elitis Windows, Doors and Conversions. For more information, call 0330 1755 790. We are about to start the second half.
It's Campion's kickoff. Swallownest defending this half now, the half that we are closer to.
Just for a reminder, Campion are winning 1-0 after an unfortunate own goal by the Nest.
Campion also.
But the match is now underway.
Campion also.
That's a throw into Campion.
Campion will also be in the red and Swallownest in the blue. And it's a shot that sails over. And it looks like that's going to be a goal kick.
Yep.
Into the Swallownest box. It's very well cleared away. It's still not out of the danger zone.
I put it down.
And this is a...
Here they come now. It's a ball
Campion,
in towards the middle.
With the ball in the box.
And it's
cleared by the Nest defence. And calls for handball there.
Nothing given though.
Referee has not given it.
Campion on this left-hand side now. Number 2 puts the ball into the box.
And it's a header. And it's going to find its way in.
Headed from the edge of the box into the bottom right corner. Unfortunately, Boof could not get a hand to it. And that is
2-0 to Campion.
0 Campion 2. But I repeat, that is 2-0 in Swallownest versus Campion, sponsored by Elitis Windows, Doors and Conversions. Oh, substitution.
Leeds are 1-0 for Spurs.
Substitution, number 7.
Coming off the pitch,
Campion
number 7. Coming
on
onto the pitch
is Campion's number 15.
Oh. And it's been kept in.
It's going to bobble and it's going to find Liam Frost here. He's able to wriggle his way out.
Oh, Liam Frost, I don't know what he's done there. But unfortunately has lost possession. Campion on the ball now.
Shot.
Campion and Booth had that covered all day. All day that was Booth's. That is a throw-in for
Campion.
Thrown
in by Campion. It's a lovely ball into the middle. Cleared away, but it's going to drop for the man. Not quite. And now here come Swallownest. Liam Frost is... Oh,
he's been turned there by Jack Haslam.
He's going to get away. Is he going to get away? It's a pass back to the goalkeeper. And then cleared away and out for the throw-in. It's a lovely ball in and it's claimed by the Campion man. And now here come Campion down this left-hand side. Do their substitute, the number 15.
It's bad language, it's not lethal.
Oh, and here come
Campion just on the edge of the area there, trying to get the ball in, but they couldn't.
And it's a shot.
And caught.
Very well
by
Booth.
Booth!
Not really.
Six.
Right forward towards the outside, towards the number 10. Now here come Campion.
I've just noticed how tall Swallownest number 5 is.
It's a shot.
Oh, he's rebounded off the post.
The bar.
Which is interesting, really. It's just little things you pick up.
And here comes the number 16, and it's
and
very good playing by Booth.
Four. Campion here to be taken.
Corner taken from Campion.
Lovely ball into the middle.
And that is cleared.
Cleared out.
Nicely by Swallownest. Unfortunately, Campion have still got him.
A lovely save
by
Stephen Booth. Thrown out by Booth. Towards the Swallownest number 2. It's fired forward. Claimed very well by Jack Haslam.
That is number 14 on the ball now. That is, what was his name? Jack?
Foul on Haslam.
Yeah, Haslam, that was it.
No advantage, says the referee, and the free kick is given on the edge of the box.
This
could
is
be
a
their
very
chance.
Good opportunity for the Nest. A very good opportunity.
It will be Ollie Screamer Grady, the return of the king, to whip this one in. Keeper's got his hat on.
Yeah, that is Ollie the Screamer Grady. Because
could we be
rumour
seeing
has it he once scored an absolute screamer.
That screamer was against Stockbridge Park. Steals this a lovely little ball, and it's
a goal for Nest! What a goal for Swallownest FC!
It's found its way in, and it's
was
a goal.
What an absolute great goal for
Swallownest
FC! That is 2-1 to the Nest. A great, great shot, whipped in from just outside the box, all the way onto his head.
That is a tremendous ball by Oliver Grady. And
it's Oliver Grady. Oh yes!
Amazing ball by Ollie Grady. And headed in by, I believe, Will Monterio, the number 8. Please correct me in the comment section if I am wrong. But that does not matter. It is 2-1 to Campion now. And Nest are right back in it. Here come Campion. And it's flicked over the top. And it's a slippage.
It's the trouble with playing on a pitch like this. Obviously, you get a couple of rough patches.
And it's a shot that's blocked very well. And it's going to drop for the number 16. And
what
it's
a
saved
save from Booth.
Very, very
what
well
a
by
very
Stephen Booth.
Good save.
And that is out for a corner on the opposite side for Swallownest.
It's really starting to lighten up this game a bit now. There's chances. It's really starting to come end to end.
And
it's just going to phase out for a Swallownest
throw. There's a throw in to Swallownest. We have just received confirmation.
Piling on the pressure now. Can they grab something?
In the last few minutes of the game.
As the day dims, it's Ollie Grady. Doesn't hit it, but will he? A foul on Ollie Grady in a very promising position for Swallownest.
That is a very good position for them to be in. We've seen them already score from a free kick.
Mark Adiali steps on the side. It's a shot
well,
that's straight
gone right into the wall, unfortunately. And that is, I hate to say it, but that was a bit of a wasted opportunity there from the Nets.
Fired forward, they stay on it. Here come Campion now. Williamson, still on the ball. It does go down after a challenge, but the referee has given nothing. And that goes out for a Campion throw.
We are in.
Fired forward. Now here comes Adiele and
is that an offside
play
goal?
Is stopped for a head injury. Mark Adiele had made his way into the box there, but play will be stopped and obviously added time will be taken into account.
And a drop ball will be given.
All the
Come
players
on, Booth!
Are heading forward.
Come on.
Stephen Booth to boot the ball forward.
Come on.
Can Swallownest get something?
I'm telling you.
Come on, Booth. We need a strong kick.
Come on,
from
Booth.
You.
Come on.
Booth fires
Your
forward.
Kick.
Headed away. A push on Cooper, nothing given. Come on, Antonio. Every single man apart from three.
I'm getting stripped off of this.
Sit into the box.
It did not mean that.
It's Ollie Grady to whip it in. Not quite one, cleared away. It's bouncing around.
That is unfortunately.
Sadly,
a 2-1 loss for Swallownest. Just a reminder, the match was Swallownest FC versus Campion AFC. Match sponsor, Elitis Windows, Doors and Conversions. For more information about that, please call 0330 1755 790. Thank you very much for watching this match and have a good rest of your day.
That is the end of the match. Handshakes down there from all the players. A very good game from all, and especially a very good game from our man of the match, Stephen Booth.
I want his signature.
We could hopefully,
by far, a good player today.
Hopefully, get some more post-match interviews for you. But if not,
I'm going
then this has been us. Goodbye and up the Swall.
Hi, welcome to your post-match interview for Swallownest Fan TV. We're joined here after the game, and I've just got some questions for you.
Yeah, that's fine, Paul.
So, just tell us a bit about yourself and your role at the club.
Centre attacking midfielder, like to get on ball and stuff. Come back to club 3 weeks ago. Obviously looking to move forward, we mean obviously push up as we can at league. So it's looking good. Obviously result today is rubbish, but we're showing good signs and we're creating chances. So it's not doom and gloom at all. So.
How do you think the team played today?
I thought we played all right. Obviously we knew what they were going to do, lump it up to big man and get off it. But apart from that, I think we second half, I think we absolutely dominated the ball. So we're unlucky. Jack should score at end, header, I think we missed. And apart from that, I think we limited him to little chances. So yeah, disappointed.
How do you think the team have done so far up to this point in the season?
Yeah, not bad. Little miss. I think if we can get a good run of games together and a couple of wins, then I think we'll be flying. But it's just obviously at the moment in time, we're a bit of a rough patch. But get that win on board and I think we'll start to take off.
Do you think that with the team we've got, we have a chance for playoffs or maybe even automatic promotion?
I wouldn't say automatic promotion, no. It's a weird one this year with league. I think everyone can beat everyone. If we get this consistency, then yeah, I reckon we can be up there. But at this moment in time, we're a bit like in between. If we get that consistency, I believe, yeah, we could be up there.
If you could have one player, past or present, from anywhere in the world join Swallownest, who would that player be?
The gaffer, Alex Nightingale. Get him a Swall shirt back on. Cheers. Thank you for your time. Cheers, mate. Thank you.
And we're also joined by Will Monteiro. Hi, Will, you all right?
Hi, yeah, good.
Do you think you played well today?
I thought we did all right. I thought as a team, I thought we had the better than them, considering they're top of the league, but I think we did really well. I thought we probably should have really at least got something out of the game. But I think we've got to keep our heads high. I mean, we've gone toe-to-toe at top of the league, we haven't lost all season, so yeah, I thought we had a good performance.
You're obviously given Player of the Month a few months ago. How do you think that you as a player have done today?
I think I've done all right. I think I've been constantly changing positions all through me like last couple of seasons, and I enjoyed it in midfield today. I thought me, OG and Dicko did really well. It felt like it was going always over us today rather than a bit of a midfield battle, but yeah, I thought I did all right.
Do you think the manager will be happy with the performance that was out there today?
Yeah, I think 100%. I think Leeds have been, like I said, you know, putting teams like 4 or 5 nil, putting goals past them, a lot of teams, and I think we've matched them today, and I think we've just got to keep doing that to all the other teams in the league, and then I think we'll start moving up the league.
Never be nervous.
Don't be
nervous.
What do you expect for the rest of the season?
I think we can push playoffs. I think there's a lot of good teams in the league. I think teams, you know, have a big squad depth, but I think we've got a really good squad. I think we're definitely capable of getting, you know, in that top six if we pick up a bit of consistency, which we showed a few games ago. I know we're in a bit of a rough patch, but I think once we start getting wins again, I think we'll move back up the table. So yeah, hope top six.
Thank you for your time.
Nice, mate. Thank you.
Hello, and how do you think you did in today's game?
I thought we were all right. In spells we were a bit tricky on a crap surface, shall I say. But it's safe for both sides, and yeah, we just need to play better in the areas.
Mm-hmm. Tell us a bit about yourself and what you do at this club.
What I do? Well, yeah, I weren't the skipper at the start of the season. It was Tom Archer, and he's less involved now, so I've stepped up to the plate and seem to try and get these lads playing.
Okay. How do you think you personally did in today's match?
I thought I was excellent. If Real Madrid are you watching, if Real Madrid's watching, I'm a player, son. Pep Guardiola, if you're out there.
And do you think Swallownest have the facilities to get playoffs this season?
Honestly, after last season, I'd think I'd just be happy with top 10. Yeah. As the gaffer said, playoffs is always the big thing that you want to aim for what I want to play in. But after last season, just last game or two, you just managed to survive. So we just came in into here and stabilised the club, and we'll grow next season.
Yeah, well, thank you for
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Any words? Anything?
Up the Swall.
Up the Swall.
I'll talk you later, boys.
Thank you very much.
Cheers, lads.
Hi, Alex. Obviously the manager today. How do you think that the team did as a whole today?
I thought we were good. I thought we were really good. Executed the game plan really well. I think fine margins between us and them. That's why they're top of the league. Obviously we missed the chances. They took their chances. But overall, I thought we were really good.
Yeah. Who was your personal player of the match today?
It's a good question. I think the whole group were brilliant today. Booby made some outstanding saves. Connor, the skipper, he's very consistent. He was excellent. Thought there were some impacts that came on, so I thought Jack Haslam did really well. Ollie Grady did really well. He had lots of energy. So I thought there were some good performances, but I'll probably go with Connor, who got the man of the match.
Well, you've obviously got you've been able to build a strong team with some of the signings that you made towards the start of the season. How do you think that the team will do towards the later stages of the season?
We just need to make sure we get consistency, because we've had games where, like Armthorpe away, where we've dropped points and actually we should have you know, probably gone on and done better in those games, just individual errors. Brig was the same, so it's just making sure we're consistent and we do. Keep doing the right things, keep having the, you know, the same attitude, because the attitude in the group is really good. I would love, you know, top 10, I would love to be up and around there, but it's fine margin between games like this game today. So if you said to me now what would I take, I would 100% take top 10. 100%.
Well, good luck for the rest of the season.
Thanks, boys.
Thanks for the interview.
Thanks for coming down, lads. Da 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 da